So now we will study hydrogen. So in previous class we have learned the laboratory method of hydrogen, how we prepare in the lab, right? So now next topic is reason for method of collection. So hydrogen is partially insoluble in water. So when we try to dissolve in the water molecules of hydrogen gas, so it is not completely divisible in the water, but it is partially divisible in water. So next point is hydrogen is lighter than air, as I have told you before, right? Hydrogen is lighter than air, but it is not collected by the downward displacement of air, since it forms an explosive mixture with the air, and leakage of the gas could be dangerous. So as I have told you before that, suppose we want to store this hydrogen, because hydrogen is light in color and it reacts fast with the oxygen and form H2O water molecules. Okay? Due to this reason, we store hydrogen gas. Okay? Next point is drying of hydrogen. So hydrogen that is collected can be dried by the passing it through the anhydrous calcium chloride. Suppose we want to get the dry form of the hydrogen gas, then we should pass anhydrous calcium chloride, CaCl2. When you pass the calcium chloride over steam H2, then you will get the pure form of the hydrogen gas, in which there will be no moisture, right? For removal of the moisture, we use anhydrous calcium chloride. Yeah, write these points, then I will explain next one. So now look at the next point, that is your precaution. So hydrogen is highly inflammable, right? And it forms an explosive mixture with the air. As I have told you, it is highly inflammable and form explosive with the air. To ensure its safe collection of the following points should be noted while we are storing the hydrogen gas, right? Due to its inflammable nature, the complete apparatus must be made airtight to guide against any leakage of the gas. So if we are storing this hydrogen gas in any container, so that container should be leakage free. There should not be any leakage from any point. Next point is the apparatus should be kept away from any flame. Right? Apparatus should be kept away from any flame. Okay? When we are storing this hydrogen gas to any container, there should not be any flame. If there is flame, then it will catch fire now. So next point is third one, the gas should be collected only after all the air from the delivery tube has been completely driven out. Gas should be collected only all the air from the delivery tube completely driven out. Okay? So we should collect the hydrogen gas, okay, which is when it is taken out from that pipe from which it is passing. So these three points should be kept in mind while we are storing the hydrogen gas in a container. So write this one. So now look at the next point, fourth. To prevent the gas from escaping through the thistle funnel, at the end of the thistle funnel should be dipped under the diluted acid solution, right? While storing the gas in the thistle funnel, this whole funnel should be dipped into the ACL so that it will be safe for the hydrogen gas. Next is gas jar for collecting hydrogen should be completely filled with water. Gas jar is there and for collecting hydrogen should be filled with water molecules, right? And made free from the air bubbles. Okay, there should be not any air bubble is there. Okay, when we are collecting the hydrogen gas now, so there should not be any water vapor present inside that jar, right? It should be completely dry and should be free from the air bubble also. Then only you can collect the hydrogen gas. So write this. Now look at the test for the hydrogen. So hydrogen is a colorless, odorless and natural gas, right? So Hydrogen is colorless, odorless, and tasteless. It is having no color and it is natural gas, neutral gas. It doesn't react with anyone, right? So hydrogen is neutral. Neutral means it is not showing any reactivity series or it doesn't react with anyone normally, right? Next one is pure hydrogen burns quietly in the oxygen with the flame blue. Pale blue flame. So when we are burning the hydrogen gas now, then you will get the flame and the color of the flame will be pale blue flame. So flame will look like blue in color. Okay? And the product can be identified as water using the anhydrous with the copper sulfate, which turns blue. Right. So when we are reacting this one with the white copper sulfate, CuSO4. Okay? That time when it reacts with the hydrogen, then it will form blue solution or blue color compound. Okay? Next point is, a burning splinter is put off with a pop sound. So its sound will come as a pop sound when we are burning the hydrogen gas. When hydrogen gas will burn, it will produce a sound and that sound will like hydrogen pop sound. So write these 3 points for the test of hydrogen.
Yes, sir.
Now look at the next preparation method, that is industrial preparation method of hydrogen. When we produce in large amount of hydrogen gas, na, that time it is called industrial preparation method. Okay? So this first method is electrolysis of acidulated water. Okay? Water is stable to heat, but at high temperature like 2000 or 3500 degrees Celsius, it decomposes very slightly to form hydrogen and oxygen, right? However, the molecule can be just split by passing of electric current. That called process is electrolysis, right? Before this, I have told you, now when we pass the electricity through the water molecules, it will form hydrogen gas and oxygen gas, right? Electricity. So that process is also called electrolysis. And first method is water acidified with dilute sulfuric acid is taken in a glass apparatus with the three connected limbs. This apparatus is also called Hofmann voltmeter. So you can see the these three types of three glass limbs are there, right? So in which one contains oxygen and another contains hydrogen. By when we pass the electricity with the water molecules, so it form hydrogen gas and oxygen gas. So draw this structure also and write the process also. Okay, now look at the Hofmann voltmeter. Okay, suppose we are taking the water molecules and electricity is passed, so you get hydrogen gas and hydrogen gas, right? So oxygen is attracted towards anode and hydrogen is attracted towards the cathode. So it is written here, cathode is negatively charged and the anode is positively charged, right? So there are total three limbs, in which in one limbs oxygen will store and in second hydrogen gas is stored, right? So water acidified with dilute sulfuric acid. Suppose water is there, H2O, and it's acidified with sulfuric acid, H2SO4, in a glass apparatus with the three interconnected limbs, right? So I have taken here H2SO4 with the water molecules, and this apparatus, this setup is called Hofmann voltmeter, right? So now look at the next point. The lower end of the two side limbs are fitted with the platinum plate, okay? So this is your platinum plate, this dark one, called electrodes. Okay, the plate connected to the positive is called anode, to the battery is called anode. So suppose this is battery, negative one, and this one is positive. So this is connected with this one, this is negative and positive, like this. Okay, or maybe it will be positive, because positive will be connected with the positive and negative will be the negative. So it is negative one, right? So while plates connected to the negative terminal that is called negative one or negative electrode. So write these second points. ठीक है. So your third point is an electricity is passed through the electrolyte for the same time. So oxygen gas accumulates at the anode and hydrogen gas accumulates at the cathode, right? So in this container I have taken water and sulfuric acid, right? And we pass the electricity by using the battery through this anode and cathode, and then it will split into H2 and O2. And oxygen gas accumulate at the anode and hydrogen gas accumulate at the cathode. So this process is called Hofmann voltmeter. Voltmeter, why it is voltmeter? Because we are applying the electricity here, right? And we know measurement of, suppose we measure the voltmeter voltage across these two points terminal, then we use that time is voltmeter. So voltmeter used to measure the voltage across the two points. Okay. So this is simple. Pass the electricity anode, this at anode oxygen is collected, and at cathode hydrogen will get collected. That process is called Hofmann voltmeter, right? So write the third one, third point.